Absolute versus relative linking. I am in the Pacific Trails Resort webpage, and if you watch the anchor tag video, you'll see that I put in an anchor tag with a reference to www.usu.edu with the GoTo USU website. This link right here is an absolute link, meaning that I told it the entire address of how to get to the website. Okay. Now, this link up here, which is another link, and I've got a couple of them. I've got one for the index page and one for the yurts page, is a relative link. Notice that it doesn't have the www.usu.edu or whatever the web page was. It just has a link to just a web page. All right. So let me show you my directory structure for this. Okay, so I have this in a folder called Unit 3, and in there I have the index page, which is this one you saw right here, and then I have the yurts page. And you'll notice the one that I have open is the index page, says so right there, and the yurts one, which you'll see is in the same exact directory. Okay, so in the Unit 3 there is index and yurts. So if a web page is in the same exact directory as the current page I'm referencing it from, I don't need to tell it www.whatevermywebsiteis/yurts.html. I just need to tell it that there's a web page I want to link to. It's in the same folder. It's yurts.html. Okay? So that's how that works. Now I'm going to go ahead and open that up so we can edit it, because I want to show you a couple of cool things on how folder structures work. Okay, so let me open it up here, and I'm going to go ahead and open the index in an editor so we can edit it. Now it's quite large font, but that's okay, so it'll be easy for you to see. So let me scroll down. There's the href equals yurts.html right there. Here's the anchor tag. Font is so large that it's taken up quite a bit of it, but you can see that here's my anchor tag, href equals yurts.html. Alright, let's go back to the directory here. Okay. Now, let's say I make a folder. Okay, remember, index is what's the page is open. So I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to call it BBB for no other reason than to call it BBB. I am going to put yurts.html in the BB folder. Okay, BBB. Now let's go back. I have a folder called Unit 3. In there is my index.html and a folder called BBB. And in the BBB folder is yurts.html. Well, now, how do I get to yurts since it is not in the same exact folder as index.html? It's in a folder within a folder. Okay, it's in BBB, with, and then there's yurts. So that's simple. Come over to my document, and here where it says yurts, I can just type BBB/. Okay, so it's in the directory BBB. Let me pull this over a little bit so you can see it. Okay, and if I spread it out a little bit, so the href equals BBB/yurts.html because I put it in another directory. All right, let's change it again. In BBBBB, let's create a directory called DDD. Okay, we'll really confuse it. Let's put yurts in there. So let's go back. In my Unit 3 folder, I have index.html and a directory called BBB. In BBB, I have a folder called DDD, and in DDD, I have yurts.html. So how do I link to that? So all I would need to do is I need to go into BBBBB, and then I need to go into DDD, and then from there, that's yurts.html. Okay, so that tells me from the relative, this is a relative link, from the relative spot I'm at, which is in index.html, how do I link to this this web page yurts.html? So it's in, I have to go first into the BBB directory, then to the DDD directory, and then it's yurts.html. Okay, so that's a simple thing. Now, let me show you this. Let's say I open up yurts.html for editing. Okay, here it is. And in this page, remember it's down in the DDD directory, which is also in the BBB directory, there's a link to the index. So how from, let's go back to the folder structure, how from yurts am I going to link up two directories to get to index.html? Realize that yurts is in the BBB, which is in the it's in the DDD, which is in the BBB, so I got to go up two directories. Well, HTML provides a simple way to do that. I can just do ..slash. Oh, let me unlock that. ..slash means up a directory. Okay, so this page I have open is yurts, and it's two directories deep, and I want to provide a link back up to the index.html page, which is up a couple of directories. So ../ will take me up one directory. Another ../ will take me up two directories. So this right here says from yurts.html to link to index.html, I need to go up one directory, up two directories, and then find the folder or the file index.html. So it's as simple as that. This is a relative link, meaning relative to the current page that I'm linking from, how do I get to that page that I want. Now, this only works if pages are really on the same web server as part of the same website. If I wanted to link to a page at USU that was down a couple of directories and it's a different website, I've really going to have to put the full path, which is an absolute link, which is the one that we saw here. I don't have it on this one. It's in this one in the index. We have to go down here to www.usu.edu. Okay, so that's the difference between relative and virtual links. Now, or relative versus absolute linking. Again, this is a absolute link because we've included the full address. This is a relative link because this one right here, because we've just said relative to the current page, index.html, where's the page you want to link to. Now, I should make a note here that you can, you know, I've just put a web address here. There could be a page here called, let's call it athletics, okay, .html. So here's a full path here, HTTP, go to the www.usu.edu website and the athletics.html webpage. By default, just this address here is going to load the index.html page that's in that directory. This whole thing right here is loading a web page at the www.usu.edu website called athletics.html. But still, this whole thing here is an absolute link because it contains the full address on how to get to it. And again, this one here, let me go up. Here's our yurts. Is a relative link because we're saying relative to the current web page we're on, what's the path to get to this yurts.html. All right, I hope that makes sense. That was a lot of stuff, but it's important to know how that works.